This video is on networks and graphs. We're going to be looking at vocabulary and key ideas. Thanks to John Short for his resources that we'll be using today. So, learning intentions are that you will know what a network is, a graph, edges and vertices, faces and loops, how to calculate the degree of a vertex, how to create an access graph, know what a connected graph is, and also understand what planar, non-planar, and topologically equivalent mean. So lots of new vocabulary in this one. So we're first going to look at a problem, quite a famous problem in the world of maths, called the Königsberg bridge problem, which is kind of one of the origins of graph theory. So question is it possible to make a tour of the town starting and finishing in the same place and crossing each bridge just once? Pause the video and see if you can do it. Well, first we should make sure we are solving the same problem. So we want to make a tour of the town starting and finishing in the same place. But if we were to start, say, on this side of the river, we could get to any of those places. So this could just be one place. This side of the river could be another. This island here could be another, and this island here could be another. And then there are ways of getting there, which we can see would be, say, from here to here, or I could go that way, I could go through there, I could go from here to here, I could go from here to here, I could also go from here to there, and that should join up, and one finally from there to there. So those are the different routes that I can take, and what we're trying to work out is, can I start at one place and go around through all of the bridges, crossing each bridge just once, and end up back where I came from. And we can represent this, so rather than drawing the map out, we can just draw those points and lines. So if we do that instead, we can take that map and turn it into this, which is a graph of a network. So it's a network of roads and bridges and places, and the graph is made up of, as we'll see in a minute, points, which are called vertices, and paths, which are called edges. Okay. Now, we won't look at how we solve or whether we can solve this problem just yet. We'll come back to that another time. So just quickly, a network is formed by objects that are connected. So a road network is an example. Here's a graph of a network, like we just looked at, of the Königsberg bridge problem. There's the Königsberg bridge again. Now, in your notes, it asks you to make three examples. So here's the first one. If you could make a note of this example of a real-world application, a snowplow towns and the minimum length of roads. Make a note of this one, which is a shortest path problem. So just make a note of the graph, please. And we'll leave that on for now. Here's the third, if you could make a note of this one. This is to do with flow, which we'll come back to later. A subway train improving, maximizing the flow of people exiting from the station. Okay. Now, we're going to look at some definitions. Here are some more types of networks that we might model using the graphs of points and edges. So a graph here is a diagram used to represent a network. The vertex is the point. The plural of this is vertices. And the edges represent the connections between those points, and so they're referred to as edges. Now, an edge can be one way. It can be directed. So for example, here, this shows authority structure. So the president has authority over the vice president and over the treasurer and over the members, but it doesn't work both ways. The members don't have authority over the vice president, at least in this organization anyway. Sometimes you also have weighted networks, and that shows you the value associated with an edge. So in this case, where it's kind of a graph of a network of roads, it shows the distance in kilometers. Perhaps sometimes a more useful map is one that doesn't show you the distances but shows you the times that it takes to get between places, which you might see that, say, on a rail network, one where it doesn't matter so much how far apart the places are, but how long is it going to take you to get from one to the other. Okay, now we're going to construct a friendship network now. So we have Alan, Barry, Carrie, David and Elsa, conveniently, whose names start with A, B, C, D, E. So we're going to make each one of those a vertex. Now, Alan, Barry and Carrie are all friends. So Alan's friends with Barry, Alan's friends with Carrie, And Carrie and Barry are also friends. They are all friends together. Alan is also friends with David. And he's also friends with Elsa. Barry is friends with Elsa, but doesn't know David. Okay. Now, how could we adjust the friendship network if Barry considers himself a friend of Carrie, but Carrie does not consider herself a friend of Barry? Well, we could make it a directed network. So if we put an arrow on there, that indicates that the friendship flows from Barry to Carrie, but sadly, Carrie does not reciprocate. Carrie is not friends with Barry, so it's only a one-way friendship. Okay. Now, an access network can show connections between rooms in a building. It says here, useful if you're planning evacuation procedures. So what we can do is make each room a point or vertex, and then the connections between them can be the edges. So here we've got the bathroom here is connected to the hall here. Bedroom one is connected to the hall. Bedroom two is connected to the hall. The hall is connected to the living room and all of those others. And then the living room connects to, we've got the kitchen diner up there, which goes into the laundry, which goes outside. Now we've made outside a point which is accessible also from the living room. So you can see how they join up there. And O is outside. Okay. Now a couple of other definitions. So far we've had edges and vertexes. Now this is called a face. I'll come on to faces in just a second. And this is a loop. A loop is where a edge comes out of a vertex and then goes back in again. So that's a loop, which is also a face here, but this is also technically called a loop, whereas this isn't a loop. That's just three points joined together, creating a face. Now, it says, for the graph shown, state the number of edges, vertices, faces, the degree of vertex A and the degree of vertex B. So, two new things. The degree of a vertex is the number of edges that come out of it. Now, that means if you have a loop, even though there's only one edge here, it increases the degree by two, because there are two actual paths coming in and out. So this B here has degree four, even though there are only three edges linked to it. Something else that's worth noting, it's very interesting, is that the number of faces here is not actually four, but five. And the reason for that is that the space outside here is also counted as a face. Now, if you were to make this network out of, say, blue tack or beads or something like that, and string or rubber bands, something like that, so that you could actually pick it up, if you dropped it or placed it onto a sphere, like a globe, you should be able to see that as it kind of drapes over that there's a fixed space on the other side of the globe, and that actually is another face. So when you put a network like this onto a sphere, you can see that the outside actually just becomes another face. So we count the outside as a face. You don't actually have to do any dropping of these onto spheres, but that's why we would count that outside space as another face. So if we look at this one here, number of edges is, and it can be useful once you've drawn it out, just to count them off. You've got 1, 2, 3, no, that's only 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So we have 11 edges. Number of vertices, well, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Number of faces, now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and outside makes 6. And the degree of vertex A is 1, 2, 3, because there are three edges coming off it. The degree of vertex B, now be careful here, 1, 2, 3, 4, because even though there's only three edges, the loop creates a fourth entry or exit point. Now, this is an interesting and important point, and it's about planar and non-planar networks. Now, a planar network means that it can be laid out completely flat in the plane without anything crossing over. Now, if you have a look at this one here, you can imagine if you made that out of, you know, physically, like a road, out of roads and roundabouts and things like that, it could be laid out completely flat. This one here would require an awful lot of bridges and tunnels in order for people not to be crashing, because here we would have things go driving into each other if we actually try to lay them flat. So we can't lay them flat. There are things going over the top. This is a non-planar network. Now, the thing is, sometimes there are things that look like they are non-planar, but in fact they are planar because we can redraw them. And what's happened here is the link between A and D has been redrawn over here to go around B. And because we can do that, it means that this network, even though it looked non-planar, was actually planar. So we can redraw it, making the network planar. It can be laid out flat. Even though these two things originally look a bit different, what we say is that they are topologically equivalent. So all we've done is move and stretch the edges between them. We haven't fundamentally changed any properties of the graph. So it's topologically equivalent. That makes them the same. So here's one here that looks very non-planar because it's got things crossing all over the place. So when you're faced with something like this, the question is, now I can move these around a bit, is to see whether can I make it so that nothing crosses. So it turns out if I pull this over here, and if I move, if I move this one around a little bit into there, look, so now I've got nothing crossing. So now this is definitely a planar graph, and I've been able to show that I could stretch it out, lay it out flat, and nothing crosses over, which makes it topologically equivalent to the original one that was all messed up with all the crosses over. So this is planar because I can lay it out flat. Now, for each of these, we're going to have a look and see, well, are they planar or not? Now, the first one here, this is planar. I haven't got anything I need to do with this one. This one is crossing over. Now, where you can't drag things around, the idea is you should draw them out and then just try and cross out something and see if you can redraw it. So if I can redraw it around the outside so it goes back to where it started from and finished, and now there's nothing crossing over, it now is planar. So in this case, I could cross this one out here and redraw it around here, and it becomes planar. And now we hit a problem here, because if I try and get rid of this one, so I get rid of that, redraw it around here. Now, I have two, I still have to get rid of one. So let's say I cross this one out. I have to start it here, but if I come round and try and get in to this one, I'm blocked by this. I can't get around it. So this one is non-planar. This one's not. This one here, or we could get rid of that and just put it off there, get rid of that, put it off there, and it's planar. So no problem there. That would be nice and flat now. So last thing is about connected and non-connected or disconnected networks. Now basically the idea is here, it's connected if you can get somehow from one point to any other point on the network. So I can get to here, I can get to here, I can get to here. They're all connected somehow. It doesn't have to be connected directly. Just has to be a way for me to get from one point to any other point. As you can see here, there's a break here, so while I can get across here, I can't get to here. So this is disconnected, and here again, there's no way to get to this point, so it's disconnected. Okay, so final recap. Vertex is a point. The plural of it is vertices. An edge is the link or pathway between vertexes or vertices. The degree is the number of paths that go into and out of a vertex. Faces are created by enclosed spaces, and not to forget that the outside of a network is also a face. A loop is where a point just goes in and out like that. Sorry, a edge goes in and out of a vertex like that. Planar means that it can be laid out flat in a network with nothing going over the top, so no need for bridges or tunnels or anything like that. Non-planar is where you can't do that. And topologically equivalent just means that it's effectively the same network. All we've done is move it or stretch it. We haven't broken anything, and we're not trying to force something through something else. So it's fundamentally the same network as before. It just looks a bit different. Okay, I think that's everything. Cheers. Bye.